Okay, let's see. Continuing with counting techniques, today the first thing that we want to talk about are permutations. Okay, so what a permutation is an arrangement of n distinct objects. An arrangement of n distinct objects. Okay. An arrangement of n distinct objects. That is a permutation. Okay. Where order matters. So I'm going to say in a specific order. All right, so with permutations, it's really important that you remember that order does matter. Okay. So let's look at permutation rule number one. Pretty easy. The number of permutations of n distinct objects taken all together is n factorial. The number of permutations of n distinct objects taken all together is n factorial. Okay, so quickly, before we get too much further, I need to do a definition for what is n factorial. So let's do a quick definition. If you have something like n factorial, for example, 3 factorial, what this means is 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? So whatever the number is, you take that number times the next smaller number times the next smaller. Okay? Whole numbers here. So 3 times 2 times 1, which is 6. Similarly, 5 factorial would be 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So if you multiply that together, 5 times 4 is 20, 20 times 3, 60, 60 times 2, 120. All right? Also to include in your definition here, sometimes you run into 0 factorial, and we have a special rule here, 0 factorial, we're defining as that's just equal to 1, okay? So please include that in your notes, because some of the formulas you're gonna be working with, you'll get a 0 factorial in there, and that's just equal to 1, okay? Okay, let's do an example. Example number one. How many different permutations can be made with the letters A, B, C? So we have letters A, B, and C. How many permutations are there? Okay, so to answer this question, we need to understand that means how many different ways can I arrange A, B, C? And every different arrangement, every different order is going to be a new one, all right? So let's start. Our rule says there's 3 distinct objects, so the answer should be 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2 times 1, which is 6. So we should get 6, all right? So let's go ahead and see if we can do all 6 here. So we have what? ABC, that's 1. We have ACB. We have BAC. BCA. CAB. And CBA. Okay? So this is every possible arrangement of these specific letters. This is every order possible, okay? And that's what we mean by permutations. So this is the 6 permutations. Any questions on that?
Yeah.
Okay? So if on a quiz or a test or a homework I said, you have 7 books, how many different ways can you arrange those 7 books on a shelf? The way you would do that is what?
7
factorial, just like this. Okay. You're using all the books, how many different orders? Okay, great. Let's go to permutation rule number 2. Permutation rule number 2 is NPR. Okay? Now, what this means is we're going to do how many different arrangements of n distinct objects, but only doing groups of r at a time. Okay? So let me write this out. So this is the number of arrangements. Using n objects, but only r at a time. Okay, so what in the world does that mean? Let's change this last example up a little bit. And let's do A, B, C, D. So let's add one letter. So let's say I have the letters A, B, C, and D, and I want every permutation, so every arrangement or ordering of these 4 letters, well, let's just do 2 at a time. Okay? So let's go ahead and do that first. So I want to do every arrangement, so every order, but we're only going to do 2 letters at a time. So A, B, A, C, A, D, B, A, B, C, B, D, C, A, C, B, C, D, and D, A, D, B, D, C. Okay, so check here to make sure that I've done every possible ordering of these 4 objects, but we're only using 2 at a time. Okay, and you see that you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the answer should be 12. And let me give you the formula here. So it's NPR. And you should be able to find that on your calculator, which I showed you just a minute ago. But the actual formula for NPR is N factorial divided by N minus R parentheses factorial. Okay? So you have 2 choices. You can plug this in your calculator, or you can actually use the formula. All right? So let's just do it in our calculator first, and then we can check it. So in your calculator, type 4P2, and see that you get 12, okay? So just like I showed you before, hit the 4 key, then go to math, PRB, NPR, then hit the 2 key, and you should get 12. Also, you could do it the long way. You'll get 4 factorial divided by 4 minus 2, 2 factorial. And that will also be 12. Okay? So either way. Permutation rule number 2. Everybody get that? So 4PR. A great example for using permutations, let's take a look at this example. In a class of 10 students, how many ways can we select a class president, vice president, and secretary? Okay. In a class of 10 students, how many ways can we select one of those students to be president, one to be vice president, and one to be secretary? So if I had a group of 3 of those 10 students, does the order matter? Well, one of them's president, one of them's vice president, and one of them's secretary, but if I change the ordering of those 3, then a different person's president, vice president, secretary. Does everybody see that? So in this case, the order does matter. So order matters, it's a permutation. We have 10 distinct objects, and we're doing 3 groups of 3 at a time, OK? Okay? So if you wanted to solve this problem, you'd do 10p3 in your calculator. So go ahead and do that for me and tell me how many different ways we can select a president, vice president, and secretary from a class of 10 students. Tell me what you get.
720.
Okay. So probably not a good example to list out every one of them, but an easier one to just calculate. All right, so again, we're just counting. This is how many different ways that can happen. 720. Permutation rule number 2. Any questions on that one? Okay. Sometimes, in your homework questions, you'll deal with permutation rule number 3. And that's if you have some repeats. So an example, let me just do an example of permutation rule number 3. How many different permutations can be made from the letters use my name. Okay, so if you have repeats in the objects, the rule changes just a little bit. Okay? So the way you handle this problem is you have 5 distinct letters, distinct objects. So you do 5, and then you divide it by, and then you go through each letter and you put how many there are. Okay. So for instance, there's 3 B's, so I'm going to divide by a 3 factorial. There's only 1, and there's only 1 Y, okay? And then just make sure that this number plus this number plus this number adds up to the top number. That's an easier way of explaining the rule, okay? So if I had to do, I don't know, I'll just make up a word. T-A-A-R-S-S, let's say this was my word. You'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 6 factorial. There's only 1 T, there's 2 A's, there's 1 R, and there's 2 S's. Does everybody see? So that's kind of the process if you have a repeat. Question?
Does it matter on the bottom, biggest to lowest, or?
No, yeah, as long as you cover them all. When you multiply, it's commutative, so it doesn't matter. Okay, so if you do this in your calculator, 1 factorial is just 1. 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial, here's what happens. You have 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1, so these will cancel out, and you'll just get 20. Okay? And we'll call that permutation rule number 3. So you have 3 permutation rules. 1, if you take all of the objects, it's just, there's 7 distinct objects, it's 7 factorial. Permutation rule 3, if you have some repeats, you would have 7 factorial divided by, and just make sure you handle the repeats. And permutation rule number 2 is you doing every arrangement of however many distinct objects, but you're not taking them all together. You're only using 3 at a time, or 6 at a time, okay? So those are your 3 rules. Questions on that? Okay, great. Once you handle permutations, then we take a look at what's called combinations. Combinations is different because it's not arrangements, it's grouping, okay? So NCR, this is the number of groups or groupings of N objects taking R at a time. Okay? So right away to see the difference, I want to go back to that example where I did A, B, C, D, taking two at a time, right? This example we just did 5 minutes ago. How many permutations did we have for that example? Yeah, there's 12. I'll list them out again. AB, AC, AB, BA, BC, BD, CA, CB, CD, and DA, DB. Yes, DB. And DC. 12 permutations, okay? If I ask you this exact same problem, but this time I ask combinations, how many different groups of these four letters taken two at a time? Okay, so notice, if I circle A and B together as a group, is that the same group as B and A together? Are these the same grouping of two letters?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so that's not going to be a new combination. So everybody see that? A and C together as a group, C and A is the same group. It's the same pairing, right? A and D is a new group, B and C is a new group, but C and B is not. B and D is a group, D and B is not. And C and D would be a group, and D and C would not. So instead of 12 permutations, if I ask you the same problem and ask how many combinations, notice there's only 6, okay? And so let's take a look at this formula. And again, you're gonna wanna find this key on your calculator. On the TI-83, it's math, then go to PRB. So to do this problem for C2, you should get 6, okay? And if you want to use the long definition formula, it's n factorial divided by n minus r factorial divided by another r factorial, okay? And what that does, essentially, is it divides out the repeated groups.
Where do you four at?
Oh, from there's four letters, yeah.
Oh, we did two
and
groups.
You're doing two at a time, yep. Okay? So, this should come out to 6. We do that in the back of it. All right, now the example that I just did with the class of 10 students, how many ways of selecting a president, vice president, and secretary, okay? So let's change that to make it a combination problem. So that same problem will look like this for a combination. Class of 10 students. How many committees of 3 students? Okay? Does everybody see why the order is not going to matter on this one? A committee of 3 students versus vice president, president, and secretary. Okay? So if I had a group of 10 students and I picked 3 of them, that's gonna be a committee of 3, right? No matter what order those 3 people are, it's still the same group. Versus if I had 3 people and one was president, one was vice president, one was secretary, if I change the order, now this person's president, this person's vice president. So the order mattered in the last question, but in this question, it's just a committee of 3, okay? So to do this, you're gonna do 10C3. So go ahead and do that in your calculator, and tell me what you get. What is it?
120.
120, okay. And what was it for the permutations?
720.
720? It's a bit of a difference, right? So what you guys need to do, it gets confusing oftentimes in determining if something is a permutation or combination. So you have to be really clear if, is this a different ordering each time? Does every different arrangement matter? Or is it just a group, a collection of objects, okay? If the order doesn't matter and it's just a group or collection, it's a combination. If every order and arrangement is different and it does matter, it's a permutation. All right? Okay.